Hello friends, in the series of fractional horsepower motor explanation, now in this video we are going to learn about capacitor start induction motor, capacitor start, capacitor run induction motor. So let's have a look on one by one. Capacitor split phase motor, the most this commonly used motor in nowadays is capacitors motor. So this type of motor is similar in construction to resistance split phase motor, except that it having a resistance rather than resistance, it having a capacitor in series of auxiliary winding. So as per the application or use of capacitors, we have three type of capacitor motors. First is capacitor start induction run motor, capacitor start induction run motor. Second one is capacitor start capacitor run motor, and third one is permanent capacitor motor. So I will explain it one by one. First, capacitor start induction run motor. So as per its title says, it is having a capacitor only in starting condition, but in running condition it will run on the inductor, means a winding. So the construction of this motor is like this. First of all, I will explain this in diagram, then we will read this slide. So main winding, which having an inductor based winding, in auxiliary winding we have a capacitor and a centrifugal switch. So the use of centrifugal switch is, once the motor gets 70 plus speed of its rated speed, then it will operate, means it will open and it will remove the auxiliary winding from the operation, and the motor will run on only main winding and rotor. It rotates with the use of main winding. So this is the use of centrifugal switch. Starting winding and capacitor is placed in a series with the starting winding. So this type of motor, as shown in figure, starting winding connected in series with capacitor draws a leading current, while capacitor draws a leading current. Please keep this in mind. While the main winding continues to draw the lagging current. Why capacitor starting winding draws leading current? Because it is the characteristic of capacitor. We know that when we connect in capacitor, the current will lead the voltage. But in main winding, we know that we have inductance, and its characteristic, inductance characteristic is it draw the lagging current. So basically you understand why starting winding carries the leading current and running winding or main winding carry the lagging current. Due to this, flux produce a rotating magnetic field which result in rotation of the motor. The current IM through the main winding will lag behind the source voltage, as the main winding is inductive, but the current IST through the starting winding leads the supply voltage by some angle due to the presence of capacitor. Hence the angle between flux produced by IM and IST will be large. In last 2-3 points we have discussed about this phasor diagram, that in starting winding or auxiliary winding we have a leading current drawn by the because of capacitor, and in main winding the current is in lagging because of inductor, and hence there is a very big phase difference between starting current and main winding current, and it result a big gap between these two. So there have some advantages because of this. Let's see that. Due to this large angle, The starting torque produced by capacitor start motor produces a large starting torque. So the advantage, because of this huge angle between starting and main winding current, it result in high starting torque. Very high starting torque will be brought because of this phase difference. As soon as speed reaches 75 to 80% of the maximum speed, the centrifugal switch is automatically open circuit and starting winding along with the capacitor goes out of the circuit. The induction motor will then be running only on the flux produced by the main winding. So in second stage, when the centrifugal switch operates, it will isolate or disconnect the starting winding or auxiliary winding, and it will run only on the main winding. So this is how it works. Now capacitor start capacitor run motor. The capacitor start capacitor run motor has cage rotor. Cage rotor means a squirrel cage rotor. This is the symbol of the squirrel cage type of rotor. And its stator has two windings known as main winding and auxiliary winding. The two windings are displaced 90 degree in space. We know that for getting the motion or rotating torque, we should have a phase displacement, and that will be minimum 90 degree, and that can be brought by a different type of equipment components by using inductor, by using capacitor, or either capacitor and resistor or inductor and resistor. We can get the phase difference. You can check my last video in which I have explained why we use the two phases, why we make two phases from the one phase, and how the motor will run, or how the motor, why the motor will rotate, because in single phase it is not possible to start motor itself. So to get it start, we have to make the arrangement, and the one of the arrangement is add a capacitor in auxiliary winding. So there are two capacitors in this method. One is used at the time of starting and is known as starting capacitor. For this capacitor run motor, we are using two capacitors. One is for starting, the other one is used for the continuous running of the motor, is known as run capacitor. So we will check out in this circuit diagram. We have, this is main winding, which is always a inductive winding, but in auxiliary winding we have made two changes. We have placed two capacitors, CR and CS. CR means it is a running capacitor which will be in circuit always up till the motor will run. This capacitor will be in operation. And CS is, this capacitor is connected in series with centrifugal switch, and we know that centrifugal switch having their function, which is at the speed of 70 to 85%, it will get operated, and hence this CS will be get disconnected after this, but CR will be continuously in operation. That's why we call this motor is capacitor start capacitor run motor. This is capacitor start and this is capacitor run or run capacitor. There are two capacitors, CS and CR, at the starting. The two capacitors are connected in parallel. As the motor reaches 75 to 80% of synchronous speed, the starting capacitor CS is disconnected from the circuit by the centrifugal switch SC. The capacitor CR is connected permanently in the circuit, and thus it is known as run capacitor. Now, permanent capacitor motor. See, the explanation is similar like last two motors, main winding, auxiliary winding, but here we have made one small change or important change, that we removed a centrifugal switch from the auxiliary winding and just placed one capacitor. That's why this capacitor is, this motor is called as permanent capacitor motor, because there is no isolation of auxiliary winding either or a capacitor. They are always in supply or in circuit until the motor will turn off. That's why we can say this is permanent capacitor motor. So, what is the advantage of this permanent capacitor motor is the very high starting torque, and the high starting torque, that means it will, we can draw up to 300 to 400% of full load torque. This is the very important application advantage of permanent capacitor motor. This is squirrel cage rotor, main winding, auxiliary winding, phase supply. We just have to connect the supply and it will run with the very high starting. See, running torque is common like last two types, but in starting we have disadvantages. Means wherever we need a very high starting torque, we have to use permanent capacitor motor. Otherwise, we can choose from the capacitor start induction run or capacitor start capacitor run motor. Reversal of rotation of this motor can be brought or obtained by interchanging any one winding. That means I have to interchange the points of main winding or auxiliary winding. Any one winding's terminal, if I will interchange them to each other, then my motor will rotate exactly in opposite direction. Means first it will be in clockwise, then after interchanging the terminals, it will run in anti-clockwise. So this is also one important point, that how can we reverse. That's why I have included this in this video also as well as in last video. Applications: due to high starting torque, the capacitor start or capacitor start capacitor run motor are used in the following applications: grinder, compressor, conveyor, fans and air condition, refrigerator. See, all these applications required a very high starting torque. That's why we use capacitor type of motors, phase motors, for these applications. This is enough for capacitor start motors. In next video, I am going to explain about shaded pole induction motor. This is also one type of FHP motor. So keep connected, be like my videos, share my video, subscribe my channel, so you will get the update time to time. And also friends, please give me suggestions. If you have any suggestion related to my explanation, if you need if you want to improve some improvement in my explanation, then please comment below. So I will improve this, I will add something new if you request. And please like and share again. Thank you very much.